If we press the fan button, we go to the fans and lights screen. On this screen, we can press the rocker switches to enable the various fans, or we can use the function keys to do the same thing. And we can click on this button to go to the light screen where we can turn on the lights. There's also a little indicator with each switch to highlight which lights are turned on and off. Notice that in general, on all screens, F1 always takes us to the home screen. It's important to have consistency in your projects like that to make it easier for your user to navigate. Let's see how all of this fits together. If we bring up our fan control screen in our project, we see that we have four standard rocker switches, which are just regular switches chosen from this palette right here. Down here, we have some static text to remind the user that the rocker switches can also be controlled via the function keys. The text doesn't do anything, it's just static text. That was all done back here in the rocker switch when we assigned F2 to this rocker switch, and F3 to that one, F4 to that one. The home button is just a static bitmap sitting on top of a screen change button, and that screen change button says go back to screen number 1. Likewise, the lights button is also just a static bitmap sitting on top of another screen change button, and it says go to screen 17, which is our lights screen. You can see the name of the screen is right here, lighting control. And we'll go to screen 17. There's our lighting control screen, very similar to the fan control. We can turn the lights on and off using standard switches right out of the palette here. This switch is controlling a lane select tag. And when it does that, this indicator is monitoring the same tag, so it changes state from on to off. Up here we have our home button, which can also be controlled by F1, and our fan button, F2. This is just some static text here. These little on and off labels are just static text, again, to help the user identify what the different states of the switch mean. Note that this screen uses a rectangle shape object to kind of group everything associated with light 1. It helps draw the user's focus to all the objects associated with this switch. Those drawing objects are located up here under the shape object palette. Notice that both the lights and the fan screens are yellow. That's another important tip. Group screens perform similar functions by screen color. It gives the users another thing to key off of as they navigate through the project. If we go to the home screen and then hit the F3 button or this icon right here, it takes us to the status screen, which is simply set up to monitor PLC tags. These bar graphs simply monitor the contents of these tags. Let's take a look at how that's done. We need to go find that screen, which is easiest. If you look at the simulation, it tells us we're on screen 8. So let's go find screen 8, which we know is orange, and there it is. Most of these are just static text. Note that while you can't rotate text in a CMOR project, there's nothing that says you can't stack text to give you the same effect. Notice that the scales on the bar graphs are actually bitmaps. Turned out it was easier for this project to get the scale we needed by creating our own scale rather than using the automatic one with the bar graph, so we just turn those off here in the bar graph. So if I look at each bar graph, all of the labels and tick marks are turned off. Once again, F1 is set up to return us to the home screen, but this time F2 is set up to take us back to the previous screen. So this is a screen change button that's set to go to the previous screen, and that's whatever screen we last visited. Also notice that we have F5 set up kind of as a secret key that'll take us to screen 12. Screen 12 is a little screen we have in the background that allows us to adjust the values of those tags that the bar graphs are monitoring. This is a cheap way for us to modify the values when it's not actually hooked up to a PLC. So let's check all that out. We'll go back to our simulator. Here's all of our bar graphs monitoring these tags. We've already seen that F5 takes us to this screen where we can adjust the bar graph values. This is just changing the values of these tags. Let's look at this first tag right here, that 21. I can change that using the increment-decrement operator. Once I'm done with that, I can go back to the stats graph and see the results. In the next video, we'll cover the conveyor control and recipe screens. That's it for this video. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.